Good morning, distinguished guests, brothers, fathers, fathers, Bishop Danny, staff and students. Before we begin this morning's proceedings, we're going to be taking a group photo just to capture this beautiful day. Mr. Portelli will be at the front of the cathedral, so especially the gentleman in the centre of the cathedral, if I can have you sitting up nice and straight, shoulders back, and big, beautiful smiles as well. Thank you. And staff seated as well in that section. If you can please find a seat, there are certainly some more seats towards the sides and clearing the aisle. And backpacks certainly under our seats. Thank you, out of the aisles.
name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
Amen.
Well, welcome, boys, here to St. Mary's Cathedral for the celebration of 70 years of Pat's Fairfield. I understand you've come in by train and you made good time. Well done. Welcome, of course, also to all your teachers, to the executive of Sydney Catholic Schools who are here in good number this morning, to my fellow priests, five of whom are old boys of Pat's Fairfield, but most particularly could I welcome and honour the brothers who are here, the Patrician brothers. Let's give them an applause. Boys, this is the mother church of all churches in Australia. This is where the church began here. And so it's right and fitting to celebrate 70 years of the college in Australia's mother church, St. Mary's Cathedral. So let's place ourselves in the presence of our loving God, pause, try to put the distractions away, and ask for God's mercy and grace. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, who teach us that you abide in hearts that are just and true, grant that we may be so fashioned by your grace as to become a dwelling pleasing to you. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the first book of Kings. Blessed be the Lord God, who has granted rest to this people. King Solomon stood erect, and in a loud voice, he blessed the whole assembly of Israel. Blessed be the Lord, he said, who has granted rest to his people of Israel, keeping all his promises. Of all the promises of good that he made through Moses, his servant, not one has failed. May the Lord our God be with us as he was with our ancestors. May he never desert us or cast us off. May he turn our hearts towards him so that we may follow all his ways and keep the commandments and laws and ordinances he gave to our ancestors. May these words of mine, of my entreaty before the Lord, be present with the Lord our God day and night, that he may uphold the cause of his servant and the cause of Israel, his people, as each day requires, so that all the people of the earth may come to know that the Lord is God indeed, and that there is no other. May your hearts be holy with the Lord our God, following his laws and keeping his commandments as at this present day. The word of the Lord.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. May God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ send you grace and peace. I never stop thanking God for all the graces you have received through Jesus Christ. I thank him that you have been enriched in so many ways, especially in your teachers and preachers. The witness to Christ has indeed been strong among you, so that you will not be without any of the gifts of the Spirit while you are waiting for our Lord Jesus Christ to be revealed. And he will keep you steady and without blame until the last day, the day of our Lord Jesus Christ, because God, by calling you, has joined you to his Son, Jesus Christ, and God is faithful. The word of the Lord.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. I will give thanks to you with all my heart, O Lord, for you have answered me.
The Lord be with you. And with a reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "Ask, it'll be given to you. Search, and you will find. Knock, and the door will be opened to you. For the one who asks always receives. The one who searches always finds. The one who knocks will always have the door opened to him. Is there a man among you who would hand his son a stone when he asks for bread? Or would hand him a snake when he asks for a fish? If you then, who are evil, know how to give your children what is good, how much more will your Father in heaven give good things to those who ask him?" The Gospel of the Lord.
Last year, boys, I read a short history of the college, and it's amazing how much has changed over the last 70 years. Back then, Fairfield was a growing but pretty much unsettled part of Sydney. Nearly everyone was a migrant and struggling to bring up their family in the new country of Australia. And they wanted the very best they could do for their children. Bishop Delaney saw the growing need, and he asked the Patrician brothers if they could help with the education of the children in the Fairfield area. They agreed, and so began Pat's Fairfield. The classrooms were dreadful compared to the conditions today. The brothers lived in a house that wasn't big enough for them, so were two mattresses which had to be placed down in the dining room for two of the brothers to sleep on. The classes were overcrowded, 50 or 60 per class. And I'm pretty sure that I read that there was one brother, Brother Foyle, I think his name, who taught English and maths and history and science and a few other things as well. He was either a genius or he was just one page ahead of the boys in the textbook. After school, another brother did all the landscaping, helped by the boys and the families, and he planted pretty much all the trees that are there now. Fees were collected each Friday, and those fees helped to keep the brothers fed and the school operating. So different to today. It was as if another world. But the school grew and grew. Academic standards improved. The school became good at football. And as the numbers got even larger, lay teachers arrived and have been a great blessing to the community ever since. Some of you may have grandparents or great-grandparents who were at school in those days. They were sent there because their parents wanted the very best they could give. Migrants are like that, having made all the effort to move to a new country. They wanted the very best for their children. And frankly, boys, the best meant that the school had to be Catholic. They wanted their children to go to heaven. They wanted them to know the difference between right and wrong. They wanted the children to be taught about God and to do their sacraments. Of course, they also wanted them to speak English well, to do maths and science and history, so that they would have a good life. Boys, it all worked so well. Pat's Fairfield built up a wonderful school community. I emphasise the word community. Strong and happy. So after 70 years, let's stop and give thanks. Congratulations to the principal and all the teachers who have decided to make the effort to come here to our Mother Church and offer thanks. In the second reading today, St. Paul spoke about the generations being enriched by our teachers and preachers. So let's give thanks for the teachers, the brothers, the many teachers who have taught us, but also the things that the boys learnt about love and strength and community. Let's pray also, as we did in the first reading. There was a prayer there, may the Lord our God be with us. Let's pray this in 2023. May the Lord our God be with us as he was with our ancestors. May he never desert us or cut us off. May that be our prayer today. Life is so different today, I find it quite scary. It's amazing and frightening what you can get off the internet. School facilities are so much better, and I bet there's no teacher who, like Brother Foyle, teaches maths and English and science and history. But whatever era we're in, we're still human. We still need God, who is our Father and our life. And we need to feel part of a good community. We need challenges in life, and we need to feel affirmation. We want to build a good life for ourselves and help others in the community as well. We want to feel that we are achieving something worthwhile in life. Well, may God bless us. May he never desert us or cut us off. May God always be with us, our families, our classmates, and our teachers. And we turn to God now and will offer our prayers of the faithful. And let's remember Jesus' words in the Gospel. Search and you will find. Knock and the door will be opened. Ask and you'll receive. Boys, let's have faith. Let's continue to build a good life and a good school. And let's trust in the goodness of God. So would you please stand and we'll offer these prayers. To God the Father Almighty, dear brothers and sisters, may every prayer of our heart be directed. For his will is that all humanity should be saved and come to the knowledge of the truth.
We pray for the Holy Church of God, that the Lord may graciously watch over her and care for her, and preserve harmony among all her members. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for Francis our Pope, Anthony our Archbishop, Daniel and Richard his auxiliaries, and all the clergy of the Archdiocese of Sydney. May they continue to govern with strength and wisdom the flock entrusted to them by the Good Shepherd. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all present members of the Patrician Brothers College community, students, staff, and parents. May they share in the passion of the patron of the college, Bishop Daniel Delaney, in his belief in the power of education to improve our human condition. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the Patrician Brothers, both living and departed, who have vowed themselves to God and to the evangelizing mission of the Church, that by seeing Christ in all, they may faithfully serve the needs of the poor and continue to inspire the hearts and minds of the world. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all who are oppressed by any kind of need, that the Lord may graciously grant them relief, that their sorrow may be turned to gladness which no one can take from them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those in our community who have died. May we always remember them in our prayer to God our Father, giver of life, in whom there is no darkness or death, and for whom their passing from this life was the beginning of life without end. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And boys, let's also pray for the Grace family. They were the people who sold their land so the school could begin. They sold at a fraction of the price, and they also donated much of their land to the parish. So the church is built on their land. So for them, their intentions, and for all generous benefactors, let us pray to the Lord. We ask Mary, the Mother of God, to intercede for us as we pray. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. May the petitions of your church be pleasing in your sight, O Lord, so that we may receive from your mercy what we cannot ask out of confidence in our own merits. Through Christ our Lord. Please be seated. Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands. Praise and glory is
yours. May this oblation, O Lord, we pray, cleanse and renew us. May it become for those who do your will the source of eternal reward. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For just as through your beloved Son you created the human race, so also through him with great goodness you formed it anew. And so it is right that all your creatures serve you, all the redeemed praise you, and all your saints with one heart bless you. Therefore we too extol you with all the angels, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, Jesus took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. Celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Anthony, our Bishop, auxiliaries, Danny and Richard, and all the clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life,
and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and
Saviour's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now forever.
Boys, we now have a precious moment in the Mass. Our Lord is present under the form of bread and wine. When he appeared after the resurrection, he kept saying to the disciples, Peace be with you, peace be with you. God wants peace for us. He doesn't want us stressed or anxious or angry. He just wants us to be at peace. So on the 70th anniversary of Pat's Fairfield, let's pray for the great gift of the Lord's peace to descend into the school community. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Would you please stand for our final prayer? Having fed upon these heavenly delights, we pray, O Lord, that we may always long for that food by which we truly live. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Boys, there'll be a final blessing in a moment, and then Mr. Karam will come up and they'll introduce a number of speakers. So after the final blessing, I think you can just sit down then, and we'll have a number of people speak. But before I give the final blessing, could I give thanks to all those who have participated and organized today? Thank you so very, very much. And the music has been terrific. Thank you, everyone over there. So would you bow your heads and pray for God's blessing? May the God of all consolation order your days in his peace, and grant you the gifts of his blessing. Amen. May he free you always from every distress and confirm your hearts in his love. Amen. So that on this life's journey you may be effective in good works, rich in the gifts of hope, faith, and charity, and may come happily to eternal life. Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever.
Your Grace, fathers, brothers, distinguished guests, staff and students, thank you for joining us this morning in celebration of our 70th anniversary. In this next phase of today's proceedings, the College's new mission and vision statement will be promulgated and presented to the community, along with a recommitment to our Archbishop's Charter. I now invite forward Dr. Anthony Cleary, the Director of Mission and Identity for Sydney Catholic Schools. Dr. Cleary is a great friend of the College, who has over 35 years' experience in Catholic education. He has a deep understanding of the critical importance of mission and values in shaping the identity of Catholic schools and systems. It is our great pleasure to have you here with us today.
Bishop Danny, Reverend Fathers, distinguished guests, staff and students of Patrician Brothers, my colleagues in Catholic education, especially Mr. Tony Farley, Executive Director of Sydney Catholic Schools, and our beloved friends, the Patrician Brothers. Today is an occasion of both looking back and looking forward. We remember, of course, the past and the great achievements, but we also keep our eyes on the future. At the beginning of this third millennium of the Christian tradition, Saint Pope John Paul II wrote, "We remember the past with gratitude, we live the present with enthusiasm, and we look to the future with hope and confidence, because Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever." And I note that this new statement of the Patrician Brothers Fairfield is Christ-centered in its presentation. In 2019, our Executive Director of Catholic Schools, Mr. Tony Farley, set about a renewal of the mission, vision, and values of Sydney Catholic Schools. So again, that they were more explicitly Christocentric and gave an unambiguous commitment to the evangelizing and catechizing mission of the Church. And it's tremendous that that essence has been captured in the work of Mr. Peter Wade and Brother Angus, Father Bob, and those who contributed to this process at Patrician Brothers Fairfield. And so that there's a synergy between the work of our Catholic schools and of one very proud Catholic school at Fairfield. All too often, organisations, schools, football clubs, political parties, businesses can lose sight of why they were founded. And that is why we have vision and mission and values statements. Because unless we keep abreast of the changes in society today and the impact that they might have on the core vision of our work, we can sometimes experience mission drift and we end up doing things which are totally removed from the core business that we were established for. The work of the Patrician Brothers, the vision of Bishop Delaney, the work of Sydney Catholic Schools has again intertwined and had a synergy throughout 200 years in Australia and most explicitly 70 years in Fairfield. We herald and give thanks to the witness and the service and the commitment of those who have gone before us. And we keep our eyes on the words of John Paul II about the person of Jesus Christ. Pope Paul VI, in Evangelii Nuntiandi, said very explicitly, the Church exists for one reason, to evangelize, to make known and loved the person of Jesus Christ. And our encounter with Jesus Christ comes to us through the Word, through the sacraments, through others. And today, I would say we have a way of recognizing it very specially. We encounter Jesus Christ through truth and goodness and beauty, the truth of the Word, the goodness of the sacrament received, the beauty of the place where we are gathered, the singing, the light, the architecture, the windows. And we think of the sacrifice that went into establishing this Mother Church of Australia. And so, on this very special occasion, we know that the work of Mr. Peter Wade, of the staff, of the guiding hand of the Patrician Brothers, of the vision and mission and values of the young men enrolled in this school, the care and concern of their staff. This is a very fine institution. And so as you set forth today, remember the commitment that you have made of continuing on this pilgrimage, 70 years in the making already. Today too, you will receive the charter from His Grace Archbishop Anthony Fisher, 9th Archbishop of Sydney, as a charter outlining the excellence of this school, but as a reminder of the characteristics, 11 identifiers, which point out to us the way in which we can actually strengthen the identity of our school community. And so with that, I now invite Zach and Jean-Paul to come forward and for Bishop Danny to bless the charter and to bless the new vision, mission, and values statement.
So boys, a lot of work would have gone into expressing this mission and vision statement, and it contains the hopes, prayers, aspirations of the community. So when I bless it now, I'll be asking God to bless your aspirations and hopes and prayers. So may these aspirations, this vision, this mission, may you be true to it, and may it keep the college growing, growing, and growing.
Thank you, Dr. Cleary, and thank you, Your Grace. It is now my pleasure to introduce Mr. Tony Farley, the Executive Director of Sydney Catholic Schools. As Executive Director, Mr. Farley oversees the operation of 150 schools across the Archdiocese, ensuring that each school remains faithful to the teachings of the Catholic Church while delivering a high-quality education to their students. We are honoured to have you here with us today. Thank you, Mr. Farley.
Bishop Danny, Reverend Fathers, and in particular the five Reverend Fathers who were students at Patrician Brothers at Fairfield, our distinguished guests, Mr. Peter Wade, our principal, the Patrician Brothers and Patrician Brothers staff, both past and present, friends of the college, and most importantly, our students here today. We find ourselves in this beautiful cathedral celebrating the day 70 years ago that young boys walked through the gates of Patrician Brothers Fairfield for the first time. Those young men are now about 80, old men with life stories that most of us will never know. For 70 years, Patrician Brothers Fairfield has educated young men, forming them in faith to be men of integrity, strength, truth, and courage. The students of those early years were born during or not long after World War II, and horrific global conflict where upwards of 80 million combatants and civilians died, where cities and whole countries were destroyed, and where lifelong trauma became the norm. It was in this shadow that Patrician Brothers Fairfield was born, and into which post-war immigrants and refugees arrived for their education. Patrician Brothers Fairfield has always been a place of ethnic and cultural diversity, where aspiration, excellence, perseverance, and achievement have been both dispositions and goals. The brothers who started this school did so in a spirit of optimism and faith that bore witness to their love of God and God's eternal love for us, and we especially thank and honour them here today. You, the young men who sit in this cathedral now, are part of this 70-year unbroken tradition. What you do each day at school, as an individual, a friend, a classmate, a member of a whole school community, really does matter, and for so many reasons. Who you are and who you become in these school years will not just influence and guide the course of your life, but also the lives of your families, friends, and the many people you'll encounter in the years to come. You'll most likely one day be that 80-year-old man, looking back on your life, the good times and the bad, the successes and the failures, and those you have loved and those you have lost. Your future is unwritten, and the story of your life is waiting to be told. By how you work, how you love, by how you give, and by how you navigate the challenges and the joys of life. I pray that you take a moment in this sacred space today and think carefully and deeply about Jesus Christ and who he is in your life. I pray that in the years to come, you realize that whether Jesus Christ is near or far in your thoughts or what you do each day, he is always with you. I pray that the transformative message of love and forgiveness he preached 2,000 years ago is present throughout your lives, and that prayer itself, anywhere and at any time, is always the right thing to do. I pray that you find it in your heart to explore the power and mystery of a faith that strengthens and protects like nothing else can in your life. It's an honour to be part of this day of celebration, and I honour every person who has worked with and for Patrician Brothers Fairfield, students both past and present, and the thousands of families and friends who have been part of the school community. Congratulations and God bless.
Thank you, Mr. Farley. I now invite our principal and proud old boy of the college, Mr. Peter Wade, forward. Mr. Wade has been a key figure in the college's success since his arrival to Fairfield in 2016. His authentic and wise leadership has been instrumental in driving the college's strategic vision in recent years, including the renewal of its mission and vision statement. Thank you, Mr. Wade.
Good morning, Your Grace, our honoured guests, staff, and can I say good morning, gentlemen. Boys, I wish you could stand where I am. It is a sight to behold. I know this morning that 1,200 boys and staff moved to Fairfield Station and then with military precision boarded the train, and then I watched my watch at 9:45, wondering where are you? And then across the park from St. James Station you emerged. Gentlemen, I am so proud of you, the way you have involved yourself in the mass, your presence, your responses and your singing, simply outstanding. I would like to acknowledge the Gadigal people of the Eora Nation, the traditional custodians of the land on which St. Mary's Cathedral stands. The Eora Nation is bounded by the Hawkesbury River in the north, the Nepean River in the west, and the Georges River in the south. We pay our respects to the elders past, present, and emerging Gadigal generations. Well, you've heard it, boys, from a vineyard to 70 years of Patrician College, Brothers Fairfield. Gentlemen, in 1909, in the midst of the flourishing vineyard and winery, the Dries family established a homestead called Ferndale upon what is today the site of Patrician Brothers College. 39 years later, in 1948, Mrs. Dries sold her property for a very small amount of money, and she was then delighted to hear that the land was going to be used as an educational centre. In August 1951, the then Archbishop O'Brien wrote to the Patrician Brothers on behalf of His Eminence Cardinal Gilroy, requesting staff for a new boys' school planned for Fairfield. As we heard, it was a rapidly growing suburb with large concentrations of people from post-war migrating from Europe. On the 31st of August 1952, His Eminence Cardinal Gilroy blessed the foundation stone for the first block of classrooms at Patrician Brothers College Fairfield, and it was officially opened on March 8, 1953. The legacy of the Dries Vineyard was commemorated on May the 3rd, 2019, with the opening of an outdoor recreational and learning space that we named in their honour Ferndale. Never could the Dries family, I believe, have imagined that out of their property would build a college standing strong some 70 years on. Today, Patrician Brothers College Fairfield continues to embrace the charism of our founding Patrician Brothers from Ireland, who set about the mission to bring faith, education, and hope to the young people some 214 years ago. In fact, 235 years ago today, it is since Daniel Delaney was the founder of the Patrician Brothers and the Brigidine Sisters, he was installed on this day, 235 years ago, as a Bishop of Kildare and Leighlin in Ireland. We are proud and privileged to share his mission of providing opportunities through education whilst also helping and encouraging young men to grow in the understanding and practice of their Catholic faith. Our mission statement would ring in the ears of the bishop, and it reads, "Evangelize through Christ-centered education for all." That was one of Bishop Delaney's maxims. He wanted education for all. Patrician Brothers College sincerely thanks our principal celebrant, Bishop Danny, for leading us in prayer and Eucharistic thanksgiving on this important occasion. Thank you, Bishop. Our concelebrant priests, for being with us today and for your ongoing support. In particular, to our college chaplain, Father Bob Bassini, and Father Ben Gandy, who work very closely with us week in and week out. I also acknowledge, boys on the altar here, that we are fortunate to have five priests who are ex-students of the college. That is something to behold. Father Bob Bossini, Father Peter Strohmeyer, Father Greg Morgan, Father John Newen, and Father Jeremy Santoso. Boys, my real focus is on these gentlemen that sit in the white satans at the very front. We're blessed to have the attendance of the Patrician Brothers today. I sincerely want to thank you for your 70 years of service and leadership to the college and bringing all things Patrician to us. I'd ask the brothers if they wouldn't mind standing in their place and turn to the boys as I call your names. Thank you, brothers. Please stand. Gentlemen, we're graced with the presence of Brother Peter Ryan, our congregational leader, Brother Paul O'Keefe, our province leader, Dr. Angus Kavanagh, Brother Thomas Rice, Brother Dominic Zurib, Brother Stephen Sweetman, Brother Charles Barry, Brother Nicholas Harsis OA, Brother Philip Mulhall, Brother Jared Bulfin, Brother Matt Mahoney, and Brother Peter Higgins. Boys, could you please give them a big round of applause? Thank you, boys. Things you might not understand or even fathom was how our school began. And the brothers, mainly all teaching brothers, one or two lay staff in the very early days, one secretarial staff, no groundsman. You would see the brothers teach you in the day, and then that very afternoon, apart from their coaching, lovers of sport, you would see one of the brothers walking down with a hose over his shoulder to go and clean the bathrooms. You would see another brother on the tractor slashing the ovals. And indeed, the ovals, boys, the seeds that were sown there were taken from runners of Kaikuyu from the creek area, and there were planting parties to really create the turf that we really enjoy on our oval today. Boys, there was not much state funding or federal funding in those days, and the brothers had to really work hard. There were monster fates, there were bottle drives, there were working bees, things that really built our community. And the thing I reverence about the brothers is this: they are people of the people. They lived in and amongst the community, and they shared the ups and downs that our community has. Again, brothers, we are delighted that you are with us today. To Dr. Edmar from Sydney Catholic Schools, executives and representatives, thank you for your continued support. I thank in particular Mr. Farley and Dr. Anthony Cleary for your very kind words today. We have members of Parliament, the retiring state member for Fairfield, Mr. Guy Zangari, and Ms. Dai Lee, the federal member for Fowler. I thank you for your continued support and friendship of the college. Past principals, assistant principals, staff, students at Old Boys Union. Mr. Green is here, and Mr. Raj Kumar, the president and the secretary of the Old Boys Union. I thank you for laying the foundations, enabling current staff to continue your good work. I wish to acknowledge the past principals present with us today. Dr. Angus Kavanagh, who was my principal while I was a student at the college, I'm actually very, very proud to call brother my mentor and my friend. Brother also celebrates a platinum centenary this year, 70 years as a patrician brother. Congratulations, Brother Angus. Thank you, boys. Also, I believe not with us today, but Brother Charles Barry, who spent many, many years in Papua New Guinea and was principal of the college. Mr. Jim Finucane, who was Brother Christopher, is also my hero. Mr. Colleen, who was the principal prior to me coming, you're very welcome. And Dr. Michael Croik, he was the first lay principal of the college. Principals and students from our patrician schools, there are five patrician schools in our network. Thank you for being here today and for sharing with our college the richness of our tradition of the patricians. REC, Mr. Daniel Karam and the RE team, for your long time preparation and meticulous attention to detail in organising this wonderful celebration. To our current staff and students at the Patrician Brothers College Fairfield, thank you. Thank you for embracing the words of the breastplate that we say every day, and to really taking that to your heart in teaching and learning and knowing the presence of Christ in everything. Thank you to our special guests, staff, to our students, for your attendance and participation in today's 70th anniversary celebration. To Mr. Long and the Patrician Brothers music staff, college musicians and choir, absolutely sensational, beautiful music, and you really lifted our spirits today and minds to God through your wonderful music. Let's give them a round of applause. Now, gentlemen, we got here by train, and there is a beautiful gospel passage where they're feeding the 5,000. We're not quite 5,000, but we are a little over 1,000. And today, boys, I really trust that you enjoy each company before we hop on a train to go back to Fairfield. I believe there is a beautiful pizza lunch for you. Boys, enjoy that. And again, thank you so much, Maria Duce.
Thank you very much, Mr. Wade. We've had the final blessing, so we just need to have the recessional hymn and we'll process out. I think there's a photo after Mass, boys, so beware of that. And then there's pizza in the park, so have a lovely lunch. Let's all stand now for the final procession.